Purdue at Notre Dame, and Notre Dame is a 7-point favorite. Purdue's running back is out for an extended amount of time here. I don't know that it makes a whole lot of difference, because as much as Jeff Brohm has talked about wanting to reestablish the running game, he has not done it. They have thrown the ball at an extraordinary rate. I was going to say exorbitant. That's it. But I don't know if I can trust Notre Dame right now. Like, they didn't look good against Toledo. They didn't look good against Florida State. I don't know that Florida State's a very good football team, as we just saw. It's tough for me to lay 7 here. My line was actually Notre Dame minus 9 here. So I'm going to ride with it. I'm going to take Notre Dame to kind of get back right. I think they'll be able to overpower Purdue here. I don't think Purdue has any kind of an advantage at the line of scrimmage. And I think that Purdue is actually worse than Florida State and Toledo. So give me Notre Dame minus 7 here.
Yeah, we're kind of thinking the same round a little bit on this one. Here's what I love. Notre Dame looked bad against two teams that they should be substantially better than, but they came out with a win. Brian Kelly's a good coach. I think they're going to be better this week than they were the first 2 weeks. With that being said, here's how Brian Kelly is going to beat up, and this Notre Dame offense is going to – I think they're going to dictate the pace of game. I think Jeff Brohm wants to play fast. I think he wants to throw the ball a lot. You talked about that. I think Notre Dame is going to grind the hell out of this game. I think their defensive front's going to get a lot of pressure. They want to slow this thing down. They're going to protect big plays, make everything go underneath. But when they have the football, the best player on the field is going to be the running back, and he is going to grind out yards. They're going to pound Purdue in the mouth. I think that's going to be the kind of game. They're going to slow this thing down. They're going to take every second off the play clock, and I think they're going to physically wear down Purdue. By the fourth quarter, this game's probably going to be tight, just like Toledo. Because I don't know if this Notre Dame team's great. But by the time you get to the fourth quarter, Notre Dame should be able to pull away. They're the bigger, stronger, more physical football team, and this is just what they do.
This seems like it could be a game where Williams finally breaks out, right? He has not looked great running the football in the first two games. This could be his breakout game. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.